Equations of Lines and Planes, Level 1. In the following series of videos, we're going to cover the equations of lines and planes in R³. Before we dive in, a word of caution. Make sure that you are familiar with basic vector operations, such as vector addition, vector subtraction, scalar multiplication, the dot product, and the cross product. We will be using various vector properties in this video series. If you're a little rusty, I recommend you watch the previous videos that covered these topics in greater detail. Alright, we will start this video series by learning how to describe a curve in 3D space. Recall from the three-dimensional coordinate systems video series that the equation y equals mx plus b does not describe a curve in 3D space. Instead, it describes a plane, which is a surface and not a curve. So how do we write an equation of a curve in 3D space? Well, we're going to need a new way of writing the equation of a curve in R³. Before we talk about the equations of lines and planes, we first need to briefly take a look at vector-valued functions, also known as vector functions. We will take a look at vector functions in greater detail in a much later video. For now, we will go over the basics, focusing on notation and how they can be used to describe the equation of a curve. In general, a function is a rule that assigns an element in the domain to an element in the range. These types of functions are said to be real-valued functions. A vector-valued function, or vector function, is simply a function whose domain is a set of real numbers and whose range is a set of vectors. Such functions are needed to describe curves and surfaces in space. We can also use vector-valued functions to describe the motion of objects through space. We usually denote vector functions by using the following notation. A vector function will take one or more variables and return a vector. For the purpose of describing an equation of a curve, we will go over a vector function in one variable. We will cover two-variable vector functions in a much later video. The vector that the function generates can be a vector in whatever dimension we need it to be. For example, a vector function in R² can be written as follows. And a vector function in R³ can be written like this. Here, every number t in the domain of R generates a unique vector in R² or R³. For the vector function in R², f of t and g of t are the components of the vector r of t, where f and g are real-valued functions, called the component functions of vector r. We can also write the vector function by using unit vectors as follows. We use the letter t to denote the independent variable, because a unit of time is used in most applications of vector functions. For a vector function in R³, we include the third component, in this case, h of t, or k-hat if we are using unit vectors. Let's first use a vector function in R² to illustrate how we can determine its graph. Consider the following vector function. We can determine the graph of this vector function by choosing values of t and substitute them into the vector function. Each value of t will return a vector with components a, b. This vector will be a position vector that starts at the origin of a Cartesian coordinate plane and ends at the point with coordinates a, b. So, in order to generate the graph of this vector function, we simply plug in some values of the variable t, and then plot the point that corresponds to each position vector. We then connect the points. Each of these points will lie on the graph of the vector function. We can do this for other values of t. For simplicity's sake, let's use the set of the integers for the values of t. Keep in mind that you can use any real number for t. Doing that, we obtain the following graph. Notice that in this sketch, the position vector is drawn as a gray dashed arrow for various values of t. Typically, we write the value of t above each point on the graph of a vector function. This way, we can specify the value of t that was used for each evaluation. Taking a look at the graph, we see that this vector function is nothing more than the equation of a horizontal line y equals 1. In a similar fashion, we can describe the equation of a vertical line by using the following vector function. This vector function will generate various position vectors that start at the origin and end at points that lie on the line x equals 2. You can imagine the graph of a vector function as being sketched by a position vector that starts at the origin and moves along the curve as the value of t increases, plotting points that lie on the curve along the way. Keep in mind that the graphs of vector functions do not have to be straight lines. The graphs of vector functions can generate circles, ellipses, and other types of curves, and not just lines. The following vector functions are examples of such curves. Naturally, we can extend vector-valued functions to three-dimensional space by introducing a third component, in this case, the z component, which is represented by the function h of t in the general form of a vector function in R cubed. Just like the vector function in R squared, a vector function in R cubed will generate three-dimensional vectors in standard form for each value of t. The endpoint of each vector would trace a curve in space as t changes. A vector function allows us to measure position, velocity, acceleration, forces, and many other quantities. For the purpose of this video series, you should think about vector functions as position vectors that vary with time. These position vectors trace the movement of the curve as time increases. We typically draw arrows on the curve to show the direction that the endpoints of the position vectors move along as t increases. Okay, and that is all you need to know about vector functions for now. We will come back and revisit vector functions in a much later video. Armed with this new knowledge, we can now start figuring out a way to describe the equation of a line in space. In our next video, we will do just that and derive three separate equations to describe a line in 3D space.